In this video, we'll try to understand how to draw heat balance sheet per kg of fuel that is burned in case of boiler trial. So the observations are given. In case of the boiler trial, the mass of fuel is 1520 kg per hour. Temperature of feed water is 30 degrees centigrade. Dryness fraction of the steam that is generated is 0.95. Pressure of steam is 8.5 bar. Coal burned per hour is 200 kg. Then calorific value of coal is 27,300 kilojoule per kg. The unburned coal that is collected is 60 kg per hour, having a calorific value of 2000 kilojoule per kg. Now the mass of flue gases which are generated are 17.73 kg per kg of coal that is burned. Temperature of flue gases is 330 degrees centigrade. The boiler room temperature is 27 degrees centigrade. Specific heat of flue gases is 1 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. And the important part is that in this particular case, we have to draw heat balance sheet per kg of fuel burn. So all the values are there and those must be per kg of fuel that is burned. For example, as you can see over here, the mass of fuel flue gases which are formed are 17.73 kg per kg of coal that is burnt. So we have written this data. So mass of steam, then temperature of feed water, dryness fraction, pressure of steam that is generated, mass of fuel burnt, calorific value of fuel, mass of unburned fuel, then calorific value of unburned fuel, mass of flue gases formed, temperature of flue gases, and the boiler room temperature. Now CPU of flue gases, they are also given as 1 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So as the feed water is supplied at 30 degrees centigrade, we can say that H1 is nothing but HF at 30 degrees centigrade from temperature basis steam table. So HF is nothing but specific enthalpy of water or specific enthalpy of saturated water at this particular 30 degree centigrade. So at 30 degree centigrade from temperature basis steam table, value of HF is 125.8 kilojoule per kg. So that we have written over here. Then H2 is equal to H weight, because the steam is generated at 8.5 bar and 0.95 dryness fraction is given. So as dryness fraction is given, we can say that it is a wet steam. So from pressure basis steam table, we can find out the values of HF and HFG at 8.5 bar. So from our steam table, we are having pressure basis steam table, we are having the values at 8.4 and 8.6 bar, but we want the value at 8.5 bar. So we can take the average of these two values. So at 8.4 bar, it is HF is 729.9, and at 8.6, it is 734.2. So it is 729.9 plus 734.2 divided by 2. So that comes out to be 732.05. Similarly for HFG also, we can add these two values together. That is 2039.6 plus 2036.2 divided by 2. So that value comes out to be 2037.9. Value of dryness fraction X is given as 0.95. So the value of H2 will be 2668.055 kilojoule per kg. So in this way, we have calculated the value of specific enthalpy of water at entry to the boiler and the specific enthalpy of steam that is generated from the boiler. Now the first part of the heat balance sheet is total or gross heat supplied, that is mass of fuel into calorific value of fuel. Now as we have to draw the heat balance sheet on per kg basis, means what? Mass of fuel that we have to take as 1 kg. So 1 into calorific value is 27,300, so it is 27300 kilojoule per kg. Out of this total heat that is supplied, some part of the heat is used in the formation of the steam, but as we have to draw the heat balance sheet on per kg basis, correct, we have divided mass of steam by mass of fuel or mass of coal that is burned, multiplied by H2 minus H1. So substitute the values and heat in the formation of steam comes out to be 19321.898 kilojoule per kg. Now we have to find out heat carried away by the flue gases. So it is MCP delta T. So it is mass of flue gases into specific heat of flue gases into temperature difference. So mass of flue gases, they are already given per kg of fuel burn. CPU of flue gases is 1, temperature of flue gases is 330, and boiler room temperature or atmosphere temperature is 27 degrees centigrade. So we'll get the value as heat carried away by the flue gases as 5372.19 kilojoule per kg. The next part of the heat exchanger is heat carried away by the unburned fuel. So mass of unburned fuel per kg of fuel that is burned. So therefore we have divided it by mass of fuel because our heat balance sheet is on per kg basis. So it is mass of unburned fuel divided by mf into calorific value of the unburned fuel. So 60 divided by 200 into 2000. And the last part of the heat expenditure is heat unaccounted for, that is equal to total heat supplied minus the first, second and the third part that we have already calculated. So total heat or gross heat supplied is 27,300 minus the first part is that of the heat in the formation of the steam. Second one is the heat carried away by the exhaust gases or flue gases, and third one is heat carried away by the unburned fuel. So unaccounted heat comes out to be 2005.912. Now we have to formulate the heat balance sheet. So the first column is that of the heat supplied, then heat supplied in kilojoule per kg in percentage, then heat expenditure, and these are the various heat expenditures, how the heat is utilized, kilojoule per kg and percentage. So total or gross heat supplied is 27,300 kilojoule per kg, and that is 100%, and this 100% of the heat is utilized in this particular fashion. So first one is heat in the formation of the steam, that is 19,321.898. So this 19,321.898 divided by 27,300 and multiplied by 100 will give the percentage of the heat that is utilized, and it is also the efficiency of the boiler. Then heat carried away by the flue gases is 5372.19, and this value divided by 27,300 multiplied by 100 will give the 19.678. So we can say that nearly 20% of the heat is carried away by the flue gases. Similarly, for the unburned fuel, nearly 2.1978 percentage of the heat is carried away by the unburned fuel, and unaccounted heat is nearly 7.347%. So if you add them together, it comes out to be 100%. So in this way, we can draw the heat balance sheet in case of boiler trial. Thank you very much for watching.